The video we decided to do was Poured Up by Rihanna. And we decided to choose this video because it encompasses many things that we've talked about in class, such as sexual agency, black queer identities, black women as sexual spectacles, modern Jezebel, excuse me. And so what I'm going to focus on right now is just looking at this video as seeing black women as sexual spectacles. I knew nothing about this video when it first came out or anything until I was hearing from other friends like, hey, bro, did you see that new video by Rihanna that just came out? You know, it's like a whole, like, strip show or whatever. So I'm like, okay, I'll see it. I'll go check it out. And then lo and behold, when I saw it, it was a legit strip show. So the thing, I feel like what brought people to this video and even to this song, I don't think it was even as popular as what it was before the music video came out, because people started seeing it as like a strip show and only looking at the women in this video, mainly Rihanna and the other black women in this video, as black sexual spectacles. Like, even in the video, you see the black women, they're like twerking in the water and got the water splashing everywhere and everything. Like, no one else is doing that but the women of color, the black women. So they're mostly seen as the very most promiscuous girls and very much so the sexual spectacles.
What I'm going to talk about is how Rihanna embodies black queer identities. During the entire video, she basically is acting like a man. She is in the strip club. She's throwing money. She is being promiscuous. But what makes it an acceptable black queer identity is that there are no men in this video. She has all black female strippers. Obviously, people can say that they're objectified. They're doing really raunchy things in the background, holding poles in places they don't belong. But I think that she embodies this black queer identity because she kind of accepts the role of the man and how she treats these women. So they're in there.
I'm going to briefly go over how Rihanna displays the modern Jezebel. Basically, like everyone touched on, she's obviously stripping in the video. She's, you know, touching herself. There's other women in the video who are also touching themselves. There are no men represented in this video. Basically, the Jezebel portion is like a person who is promiscuous or considered, you know, to be, I guess, out there. And she's definitely portraying this in her video. Even with her outfit, she has on barely anything. She has, you know, basically panties and a bra. So she's displaying this modern Jezebel just through all the, you know, illustrations we have in the video.
And lastly, I'm going to talk about sexual agency. And just to you know, retouch on all of the themes that we talked about here, this video would essentially be an hour if we went back through every book and tried to pick out. We can actually get all these themes from every reading, so, you know. But what we missed in the video was some vaginal play. And, you know, that can be seen as sexual agency or the whole video. You know, someone would argue that is sexual agency, but I would argue that it isn't. It actually is promiscuity to me. She's practicing sexual agency, and I think that's the politically correct term to say in a classroom setting. But it's promiscuity, to say the least, or maybe to say the most. So again, there's this with especially Black women being promiscuous and Jezebels and things of that nature, and we'd like to call it sexual agency, to be correct, but that's not what I think. This is not about me, but thank you.